This video will walk you through the TraumaCad Neo planning procedure for total hip replacement. Once you log into Quentry, you will see a list of patients. Start by selecting the patient that you wish to plan for. You can then inspect all images that are available for this patient. You can check what images you have for this patient by opening the folder. There's only one preoperative image, so it's automatically selected. Next, launch the TraumaCad Neo software by selecting the button in the toolbar. The previously selected image is automatically loaded into the software. The software walks you through the different steps of a planning workflow via the cards on the left. The first step in planning the surgical procedure is to define the image parameters. TraumaCad Neo has automatically detected that this is an anterior-posterior image and not a lateral one, and the existence of a Kingmark calibration marker. So at this point, you can simply confirm that these parameters are correct. The next step is the surgical procedure definition, where you will review and define certain properties. In this case, the software has automatically detected the anatomical region as the pelvis region and is suggesting a total hip replacement. Now, all you need to do is review these parameters, define whether it's a pre- or post-op image, and choose the correct treated side by selecting either right or left. Select Confirm to move on to the next surgical planning step, which will involve measurements and templating as indicated by the surgical planning card. Let's first add some measurements. The Center of Rotation tool gives you an indication of what the leg length discrepancy is, as well as the offset parameters. This constitutes the full evaluation of the anatomy of this patient. Once you select the Center of Rotation tool, TraumaCad Neo automatically places the tool on the image and positions it. The cup size is determined based on the diameter measurement of the femoral head. Use the markers to adjust the tool to the reference points. Once the cup and stem implants have been added to the plan, the Center of Rotation tool displays both the preoperative and the expected postoperative measurements. Make sure you review and adjust their position before you accept the results. When you're happy with the parameters shown on the image and on the Center of Rotation card, confirm the preoperative assessment by selecting Confirm. Next, you can start adding templates. Select the Templates tab to see a list of previously used implants. If you want to look for a different implant, type in the search bar and see the search results directly below. Choose your desired template from the list by selecting it to have it automatically placed on the image. As you can see, TraumaCad Neo places the cup on the image using the size that was previously selected for the Center of Rotation measurement tool. At this point, you can perform minor corrections and adjustments to both the implant or the measurement tool. Let's say the cup seems too small. You can increase the size by dragging the external diameter slider to 50, for example. Notice how the appearance of the cup changes on the image. You can also change the inclination angle from 46 degree to 40 degree. Let's try moving the cup to a more realistic position. Once you're pleased with the cup placement, the next implant template you should add is the polar stem. Select the Templates tab on the left again and search for a different one. Once you find the correct implant, select it, and it is automatically positioned on the image in the right location and size, just like the previous one. What you should do first is review the size. To go one size down, drag the slider on the left. You can also move and rotate the stem until the outcome is what you're looking for. As you can see in this example, the preoperative right leg is 4.4 millimeters too short, and the postoperative outcome is 2.9 millimeters longer, which means that the attachment points need fine-tuning, namely the attachment points of the head on the stem in the case of a modular stem system like the polystem. So let's choose a different number of attachment points from the template card on the left, for example, 8. As you can see, the postoperative leg length discrepancy is now level at 0, which is the desired outcome. To visualize the postoperative result on the image, select Attach Stem to Cup from the card. TraumaCad Neo performs the virtual osteotomy, moving the femur with the stem, thus allowing you to see how the surgery will modify the patient's anatomy. In addition to the main workflow tools, you have a set of simple tools that you can access by selecting the Tools button at the top left of your images. These tools can be useful if you find yourself wanting to add extra measurements and annotations to your planned images. For example, you can add an annotation here about the King Mark calibration. To place an annotation somewhere on your images, just select the tool, click somewhere on the image, and enter your comment. The text annotations are movable. So once you're happy with your plan, you can move on to creating a surgical report by selecting Create Report. TraumaCad Neo presents you with an interface that has all the information compressed into one view. On the left side of the screen, you have a summary of the tools and implants that you added presented in a concise manner. To complete TraumaCad Neo surgery planning, select the surgery date from the calendar, then add a comment to the report if you want somebody else to review this plan. You have the option of going to the Data to Display drop-down menu and only selecting the data you wish to have displayed in the report. You can change the font size, use a different color for the text and background, as well as adjust the position of this annotation box by moving it to a different location. You have the option to see the report in PDF format by selecting View PDF. You can choose to save the report locally or print the PDF. Lastly, you'll save the case back to Quentry by selecting Save. This marks the end of the TraumaCad Neo planning procedure for total hip replacement. Hopefully, you found this video useful.